a measure of greatness in a scientific idea is the extent to which it stimulates thought and opens up new lines of research. We have with us an eminent professor of physics and dean faculty of science and technology, Mangalore University, Professor K. M. Balakrishna, as president of this program. Sir, the stage is open for your presentation.
I have been forced to take up this president of this function, because our in-charge vice-chancellor is not available today. So being the dean of the science faculty, I hope I do the justice to the position given to me in this August gathering. Dignitaries on the dais, I don't name all the people because you know all of them and you have already heard them. They are all the people on the very high stake when I talk about, say, the digital technology or its use in cashless. We have very less cash in our hands. So in this society, we are going further to do the best in the, you know, in the technology, using the technology for doing better things in this digital India. That's our Prime Minister's motto. We have to make everything digital here. So I have few things to, you know, discuss here with the stalwarts. Sir, our country is of, you know, it belongs to the uneducated class rather than the educated class. I don't say in terms of degrees, you know, we have about, say, 400, 500 people here, and very few are using digital technology here. This is because of the education that we have, you know, all these years. Probably very few are using, say, the cards, very few are using online transactions, and very few are very, confident of using them. This may be because of, you know, the newspapers give a lot of information about the hacking, the misuse of, say, the technology and other things. People believe that rather than whatever we say. So the education should start from the, as far as possible, from the lower level on digital technology. That is more important in this country. Because my you know, youngsters in this area, the students, say, of 7th standard, 8th standard, they use these gadgets very easily rather than we people. If you ask, you know, one of my, say, the younger man, he will immediately do the things, you know, with the finger tip. Wherein if you ask me, I'll be a little slower. And it's difficult for me to understand that also. Of course, since 1988, I am with the computers. You know, I'm the first man to use, say, the computer in this campus for all the works. And I was one of the person, you know, here, he used to tell me, you can repair anything from chappal to computers. So I developed with the technology. Now I'm using, say, my mobile to do all the transactions online. But still, many of us are not in that position. So we need to educate them, and that is more important. And our university as such is doing very well. Our people here are technologically advanced in many things, and they are going with that pace. So I support them as a dean of the faculty. I know I really support all my fellows doing well in this area. And I request you all to support our university and make this a digital university as early as possible. Because we have a lot of infrastructure here. Only thing is, you know, we need to, we need a good support, financial as well as the technical support from the, you know, the world. So we expect that from you. And I appreciate all the outsiders who have come here. for this program a success, and you must get all the benefits of our HR Rao. I use that word HR, I did not use Raghavendra Rao, because HR is human resource development. So he will be the person to take you to that level, so that you will all be digitized at the end of this program. I wish all the participants, the university department people, our own colleagues, to have a fruitful time, and wish you all the best. Thank you. And on personal behalf, I thank all the stalwarts here, Professor Vatal, Satpati, Dr. Rao, and then there is one more Dr. Rao, so all of them are here, and I thank them for their presence here. Thank you, Anna.
Our registrar tries to add a note here, sir.
Back to the mic once again. This is just only to confirm. Ratanji, I think you have already set the tone and the ball rolling. On behalf of the university administration, I have always been with the vision that we are going to be the change. If you want change, you are going to be the change. Apart from this becoming a cashless society, I always feel that this as an outreach program, as we discussed yesterday, how about involving the banking sector themselves, so that this becomes a nodal center for training the staff of the banking sector itself. Probably that way, I think, as an institutional program, as well as our university as a social obligation, I always feel that we can reach particularly the consumer at the end of the door, at the end of the pipeline. So I think Mangalore University could really facilitate in that way. And if there is anything under your arms, if there is a fast track court, if something could be initiated towards that, you can be rest assured that the days to come, we will be on the fast track. I will ask Mr. Shekhar and my other esteemed colleagues for their cooperation in initiating this. And to set the ball rolling, as my dean just suggested, as I was trying to tell, to begin with, let us begin it at home. I will look at the possibilities of how a cashless society could be started in our campus itself to begin with, to set the ball rolling. And what the I have to look at the the framework of how I could bring about the amendments or the changes. And finally, we did dwell upon technology transfer. That's the reason I have one of my other good friends here. We have, this place is becoming an educational hub. We have got quality education, both in terms of technology-wise. We have a representation in Mr. Majunath Bhandari from Sahyadri College, and we are very close to NITK also. If technology and pure science could come together, and I think Mangalore University would take, particularly when you mentioned urbanization. Urbanization is a greater and a bigger role that we could play. Though this is purely a science technology, but still with my counterparts across the board with me, I think they will have me in good stead, and I will try to live up to your expectation even on that front. If need be, I will try to plan up with, I will sit across in a day or two, I will discuss with him today about urban planning. I will just set the ball rolling. And my last appeal to the organizers, we have been talking about renewable energy, environment, etc. My esteemed colleagues, the university has already taken an initiative to make this not just as a theme. I have not believed in terms of celebrating one day programs like Environment Day, etc., etc., etc. We have made this campus to be a plastic free campus, and campus known for something. You know, with this cashless society, I think my mind goes somewhere. If I have reduced paper, use of paper to that extent, I will lay a claim for the carbon credit. That is what I look at. So in this way, I appeal to my esteemed colleagues, henceforth, you have given the bouquet, I have been on this appeal always, because we have made this as a plastic-free campus. Let us become the examples ourselves. Please refrain from giving this bouquet, give a sapling. You know, I have to just go and thank my younger friends who are there. They have done an exemplary work in the last 1 week through our NSS outreach program. I am going to grace that only to thank my young friends there. They have done a wonderful job in the last week. So, to set the ball rolling, at least in the concluding session, I look forward that these bouquets are going to be, of course, flowers are always a welcome thing. But of course, flowers on the plant itself is much more to be appreciated. At least to this extent, you can reduce the plastic and also live by example. Just when I passed that one, made that remark in the last academic council, somebody asked me, what about the water bottles which you have, the plastic carry bottles which you have? Try to find a better means of replacing them also. Please, I thank you. With this appeal, thank you, and I wish all the best to everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your so many words. By presenting a memento as token of our gratitude and appreciation. Thank you, sir. Now I request Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash, Registrar, Mangalore University, to present a memento to Chief Guest of Honor, Sri B.N. Satpathy. Thank you, sir. Now I invite Professor Manjaya D.H. to present a memento to Sri Rajeshwar Rao.
Namaskaragulu, very good morning to all ladies and gentlemen, respected dignitaries on the dais, of the dais. It's our duty and responsibility to make us, overall, with us, a great attitude, and it's our responsibility with a great gratitude. Before concluding the final event of the inaugural ceremony of our second GIAN program from the Department of Computer Science, just I say few words. A digital payment stands for 3 S. First and the foremost is a simple one. It looks like a simple one because used to be in front of the man-made machine. Because through in which way you can go through the login, whatever it may be, a thing. The second is directly comes very clearly, the smartness as well as a secured one. If you say login in front of the machine, but it has its own records and a different type of an entities, as like a login, then followed by the encrypted level of an information flow, what you call a password, the GID, UID, followed by the user details, followed by the identity of where exactly the location. This indicates a various type of a technology and the information automatically provide an excellent knowledge, which what we are going to be study all among 5 days with an extensive knowledge, expertise from great a professor Ejimadi Raghavendra Rao. see the things are which are going to be very systematic, like in which way the algorithms, the technology and the technique which are going to be incorporated, which are a stand highly secured one. The third, which none other than a super fast. The fast indicates with respect to the distance, with respect to the architecture, with respect to the in which way the scalability of the user, which are always stands, we can say a different strategies. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my duty and the responsibility to make a vote of thanks who are all behind it, make this inaugural ceremony very grand success. First and the foremost, with his absence, our honorable Vice Chancellor, who has taken a very great, a challenging, and the President remark, who are other than, none other than Professor K. M. Balakrishna sir, a Dean, Science and Technology faculty, who is there and given a very good, remarkable event for this inaugural ceremony. I am very thankful to you, sir, for your presence. And then followed by three important pillars, because none other than the Government of India, Niti Aayog, extensive support with all things. I request who are all present here, the great, kindly give a great applause, who are all the person encouraged. This is our second GIAN program from the Department of Computer Science organizing. And first and the foremost, I would like to very profuse a vote of thanks to great Sri Ratan T. Watal, who is on the way with his busy schedule, with an advisory, with all support, financial and every support. And I am very thankful to you, sir, for all your presence. Then followed by Sri B. N. Satpathy, who is there, interactive and the bridge between organizer and the consultancy which related to the institution, who is present here. I am very thankful to you, sir, present. Then a great personality who is an expert, providing an excellent knowledge, a listenable our capacity, a knowledgeable and highly how the provoking thought which are going to be take place from 23rd to 27th, none other than great Professor Ejamadi Raghavendra Rao is here. I am very thankful to you, sir, for your great presence. And also, together with Professor Rajeshwar Rao, present here for this inaugural ceremony, I am very thankful to you, sir. And also, who are all present, a great administrator, beloved Register, Professor Nagendra Prakash, present here. I am very thankful for all your motivation and inspiration to you, sir. And here, with all support, a great personality, Sri Manjunath Bandari from Sayadri College of Engineering Chairman, and who is present here as a witness to inaugural ceremony of this Digital Payments GIAN program. And finally, last but one, a great people, with all your inspiration, motivation, participant from various organizations, different institutions, we are here, is indeed privileged. And once again, I am very thankful for all your kind attention, kind cooperation for me make this very inaugural function very successful one. I thank you, each and every person who encourage make this inaugural ceremony very grand success. Thank you, one and all. Have a good day.
On behalf of all present here,